Big news has now arrived on Gunners. You want to know all the details, so follow me until the end of the video. But first, if you are in love with Arsenal, show your love and subscribe to THE channel now and turn on notifications. Here we post daily news and behind the scenes of the biggest club in THE Premier League, Arsenal. Thank you. Arsenal set for £119 million windfall in summer transfer window amid Mikel Arteta's plans. Arsenal is poised for a lucrative summer, with Mikel Arteta potentially receiving a significant boost for his squad's Premier League campaign in 2024-25. The Gunners could be in line for an unexpected financial windfall following the conclusion of the UEFA Euro 2024 Championship, which kicks off next week in Germany. 11 of Arsenal's top players have been selected for the tournament by their respective national teams. Declan Rice, Bukayo Saka, and Aaron Ramsdale will represent England under Gareth Southgate. Kieran Tierney will play for Scotland, while Kai Havertz is expected to lead the host nation, Germany. Other notable selections include William Saliba for France, Oleksandr Zinchenko as the captain of Ukraine, David Raya for Spain, Jorginho for Italy, Jakub Kiwior for Poland, and Leandro Trossard for Belgium. Due to this, Mikel Arteta's squad will benefit from UEFA's club benefits program, which compensates clubs for releasing their players for major tournaments. This scheme has been in place since the 2018 World Cup and operates as a form of reimbursement for clubs. UEFA has confirmed that the distribution system will likely remain similar to that of Euro 2020, allowing us to estimate potential earnings for each club. The total amount paid to clubs has been increased from €130 million, £110 million, to €140 million, £119 million. Each club receives a fixed amount per player per day, with payments commencing 10 days before the team's first match and continuing until the day after their elimination. During Euro 2020, a top-tier club like Arsenal received €8,700, £7,400, per player per day. With 11 players in just the group stage, the Gunners are set to receive between £1.5 million and £2 million. However, this amount could increase significantly if more players advance further in the tournament. Given that 8 of Arsenal's 11 players are representing the top 5 European nations according to FIFA's world rankings, the club stands to gain even more. Following the 2022 World Cup in Qatar, which occurred mid-season, Arsenal received £1.5 million, with each club getting £8,200 per player per day for the tournament, where 11 Arsenal players also participated. This influx of funds could be a game-changer for Arsenal's transfer plans, providing Mikel Arteta with additional resources to strengthen his squad and mount a serious challenge for the Premier League title in the upcoming season. Arsenal withdraws from £110 million transfer race as Kieran Tierney eyes dream exit. Here's our take on the latest Arsenal news and transfer rumors as the club gears up for the summer transfer window. It's clear that Arsenal is targeting a striker with the summer transfer window set to open next Friday. However, this time, the club must be more cautious with its spending after splurging over £200 million on Declan Rice, Kai Havertz, and Jurrien Timber last year. Having invested heavily in two midfielders and a defender, it's now time to bolster the Gunners' attack. Several forwards have been linked with a move to North London, including Joshua Zirkzee, Benjamin Sesko, and Victor Osimhen. With that in mind, here's a roundup of the latest Arsenal news and transfer gossip as of Sunday, June 9th. Arsenal withdraws from Victor Osimhen race. Napoli star Victor Osimhen has been heavily linked with a move to Arsenal as Mikel Arteta looks to add a striker to his squad this summer. Alongside Sesko, Osimhen was identified as a potential signing. However, Sky Sports Italy, via Metro, reports that Arsenal has informed Napoli they will not meet Osimhen's £110 million, €130 million, release clause. Despite holding the Napoli star in high regard, the Gunners are unwilling to pursue a deal due to the steep costs involved. The report adds that Napoli has yet to receive any concrete offers nearing this value, while clubs from the Saudi Pro League could afford such a high fee. Football.London says, to comply with profit and sustainability rules, Sesko represents a more financially viable option with a £55 million, €65 million, release clause. Additionally, Osimhen's injury history could be a concern. Since joining the Italian Giants in 2020, the 25-year-old has suffered injuries in each of the past 4 seasons. Kieran Tierney's future remains uncertain. Kieran Tierney's future at the Emirates Stadium remains in doubt after his return from Real Sociedad. However, a report from Caught Offside states that Tierney would love to return to Celtic. It's reported that Arsenal is ready to listen to offers for the 26-year-old. Tierney has struggled to secure a spot in Mikel Arteta's team but rediscovered his form in Spain, starting 14 out of 19 matches. Football.London says, it's no secret that Celtic is a place where Tierney previously excelled. He has made it clear there's a strong chance of leaving Arsenal permanently this summer, which would be a good deal if the club can offload him. As things stand, Tierney is behind Alexander Zinchenko, Jurrien Timber, Takahiro Tomiyasu, and Jakub Kiwior in the pecking order for the left-back position. By making calculated moves this summer, Arsenal can better position themselves for success in the 2024-25 Premier League campaign while adhering to financial prudence and team needs. I played for Arsenal and Chelsea, Benjamin Sesko should join only one team. Former Arsenal and Chelsea midfielder Emmanuel Petit has weighed in on where RB Leipzig striker Benjamin Sesko should move this summer. According to Petit, Sesko should turn down Chelsea and head to Arsenal instead. Both clubs are eager to sign the talented number 9, and with reports of a £55 million release clause in Sesko's contract, it's no surprise that the Slovenian striker is heavily linked to a move to London. Both the Blues and the Gunners have been working to lure Sesko for weeks, with the RB Leipzig star reportedly open to joining either side. However, Petit, who has played for both Arsenal and Chelsea, believes Sesko would be wise to choose the Gunners. He should definitely choose Arsenal over Chelsea, the 53-year-old said in an exclusive interview with Football London via best online poker sites. Why? Because of the way they play and the backbone of the team, they've been playing together for at least 4 or 5 years. They have improved a lot individually and collectively. They have a proper playing philosophy. And the environment as well. I think it's much better at Arsenal than at Chelsea, even though things have improved a bit at Chelsea in recent months. But while it's a new era at Chelsea, the stability lies with the Gunners. So, if I were Sesko, there would be more green lights to go to Arsenal rather than Chelsea. Sesko, 21, joined Leipzig last summer after two successful seasons with their sister club, Red Bull Salzburg. Despite a slow start to the campaign, he netted 11 goals in 16 Bundesliga appearances, including 7 in 7 matches to finish the season strong. The highly rated youngster, standing at 6 feet 5 inches, has been compared to stars like Zlatan Ibrahimovic and Erling Haaland for his pace, strength, and versatile skill set, drawing envy from many top-tier strikers. Sesko began his career in his native Slovenia before moving to Salzburg in 2019. He was then loaned to Austrian second division side FC Liefering, where he scored 22 goals in 44 matches. He returned to Salzburg in 2021 and netted another 29 goals before moving to Leipzig in 2023. Arsenal is desperate to add a prolific goalscorer to their squad after falling short in the Premier League title race for the second consecutive season. Mikel Arteta remains unconvinced about Gabriel Jesus's long-term suitability as the lead striker, having deployed Kai Havertz up front for much of the season. The Gunners have also been linked with moves for Brentford striker Ivan Toney and Newcastle star Alexander Isak, among others. Chelsea, meanwhile, has been on the hunt for a reliable goal scorer since Romelu Lukaku's £98 million transfer failed to deliver. They signed Nicholas Jackson last summer, and while the Senegalese striker scored a respectable 17 goals across all competitions, the Blues are looking for a number 9 to lead their attack. Petit spent 6 years in English football. He joined Arsenal from Monaco in 1997 and helped the Gunners achieve a league and cup double in his first season at Highbury. The midfielder quickly formed a formidable partnership with Patrick Vieira, but it was cut short when Petit left for Barcelona in 2000. After a year in Spain, he returned to the Premier League, with Chelsea beating out Manchester United and Tottenham to secure his signature. However, his time at Stamford Bridge was disappointing, marred by poor form and injury problems. The 1998 World Cup winner, who earned 63 caps for France, retired a year after leaving Chelsea in 2004. He later admitted to regretting his move to the Blues, revealing that his wife convinced him to snub United in favour of a return to London.